Professor from College of Fisheries welcomes you all for today's webinar session on the topic of entrepreneurship opportunities in aqua clinics. Before starting this session, I feel extremely honored to introduce our today's speaker. Dr. Ravi Kumar sir is a founder of Ravi Aqua Academy and is a partner for Blue Star Marine and Alpha Biological Industries, Nellore, Andhra Pradesh. Our Dr. Ravi Kumar sir completed his master degree in aquaculture and PhD in shrimp pathology from Acharya Nagarjuna University, Guntur, Andhra Pradesh. After his education, he started his career as technical officer in Quality Feeds Private Limited in the year 1994. And he worked in different positions in the private industry. In the year 1997, he started his own laboratory, that is Alpha Biological, to provide the service to farmers. You can see I have marked a red circle. He is our Dr. Ravi Kumar sir, who is standing in front of Alpha Biological Laboratory. Here they provide services like water quality analysis, shrimp and fish disease diagnosis, and several others to the farmers. Apart from this, he also conducted research field trials for aqua health products of Himalaya, Kemin, Asia Pacific, and several others. So you can see some of his photographs. Moreover, he routinely conducts training program on various aspects of aquaculture in India, Bangladesh, and Iran. You can see some of his training program photographs. He trained n number of technician and field staff in our aquaculture industry. And there is one interesting photograph, so which I have obtained from his Facebook account. See, this photograph was taken at Kavali area, where he was giving first lecture in the farmers meet. So this photograph was taken before the outbreak of white spot syndrome virus in India. So that is an interesting story about this photograph. And you just imagine, he has started from there until here, how many field staff or how much human resource development he has developed for our aquaculture field. Also, he uses social media or virtual platform like YouTube, Facebook, Zoom to transfer his knowledge on aquaculture technologies. You can see his Facebook account. Here you can get so much information about aquaculture technologies. And interestingly, see, dear participants, if you surf in the YouTube, you will get Ravi Academy, which contains 76 videos related to different aspects of aquaculture, such as pond preparation, feed preparation, water quality management, biology of shrimp, molting in shrimp, disease management, biofloc technology, tips to farmers, students and entrepreneurs, several others. So here in this photograph, you can see he has 11.3K subscribers. So we are very lucky that in his busy schedule, he accepted our invitation to deliver the lecture in this webinar session. I'm pretty sure that the information going to be shared by our Dr. Ravi Kumar sir will help our students and other participants to know about the industry Aqua Clinic laboratory setup and its services with budget plan. With this brief introduction, on behalf of my institution and organizing committee, I extremely happy to welcome our stalwart Dr. Ravi Kumar sir for this webinar session. I welcome you, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Also, I extend a warm welcome for our honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Indrajit Singh, sir, and Dean College of Fisheries, Dr. Meera Madam, and Dean College of Veterinary, Dr. SPS Gumman, sir, and our Head of the Department, Dr. Vanit Madam, for this webinar session. I also welcome our organizing committee, Dr. Anush Tyagi and Dr. Amandeep, and our faculty members. Finally, I welcome all the participants for this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Naveen. Welcome all the students. My connection to this university is through Dr. Prabhujit Singh. Hi, sir. Good morning, Prabhujit
Singh. Good morning, sir.
Yeah. Some real excitement.
Dr. G here. Good morning, sir. Welcome, sir.
So, can I share my presentation?
Yes, sir.
Naveen, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Dr. Naveen.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Ravi, sir. Good morning.
Yeah.
Dr. Prabhujit here. How are you, sir?
Yeah, I'm good, sir. How are you?
I'm fine. You are most welcome, and we are highly thankful, sir. You have, you know, accepted our invitation, sir.
Welcome, sir. Really, I'm excited to share my story. Its topic given to me is on entrepreneurship opportunities in aqua clinics. In fact, it's
we are excited to really, listen to you, sir. Please carry.
I'm sharing my story so that students can get some motivation.
Yes, sir. That will be great. Yes, sir. Please carry on.
It is required, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let us go to the almost 67 participants are there. Really great. So let us dive into the subject: entrepreneurship opportunities in aqua clinics. Right. So how many of the students are really interested in setting up an aqua laboratory? How many of the students are really interested in setting up an aqua laboratory? Please comment. How many of you are really interested?
Dear students, if you want to answer, please unmute and answer.
Okay, so what is our responsibility as a fishery student? Our responsibility as a fishery student is to make aquaculture profitable, and food safety is another aspect, and aquaculture should be sustainable and environmentally friendly and socially responsible. But as a person, we have another goals like making money, making our living, and getting fame. These at the level, it's our personal goal, but collective goal is to make aquaculture profitable and sustainable and environmental friendly. So aqua clinics help in this way. So I'll give you an example. My mentor always used to say that riches are in niches. Suppose if you go to a doctor, if he is a general physician, how much fees you pay him? And if he is a specialist like cardiologist or neurologist, how much you pay him? We pay him much more to a specialist. So I request all the students to select a particular niche and become a specialist in that. In my case, I have selected shrimp pathology and become a specialist. That is why people are paying me better than other people. And you always focus on results to the farmers. Never focus on money. Money is a byproduct as a consultant. Never focus, never ask the farmer for money. If he is getting benefits, naturally farmer will pay you much more than you expect. So always I suggest you to focus on reserves and never ask for money. Money is a byproduct. Please remember, it's a golden point. And always focus on multiple streams of income after setting up an aqua clinic. I'll tell you how I'm getting multiple streams of income in the next slides. So as a student, when you enter into the field, when you enter into the industry, you have different challenges. The first challenge is, especially if the students are from Andhra Pradesh, farmers are having more than 30 years of experience. So after coming to the field, you have to help your farmer who has 30 years of practical experience, hands-on experience. That is the biggest challenge. And second thing is, there are seniors working in the field for the past 30 years, and you have to compete with them. And the third challenge as a fresher is, there are already existing labs. So how to go ahead with these challenges? For example, if you take a fish farmers, they adapt very slowly to the new technologies. As a fresher, you have to learn the new technologies and come to the field. And another thing is, seniors, if they have those who have more than 30 years of experience, they won't go to field. They will confine to the only office. And existing labs, I'll have another strategy how to compete with existing labs. And see, among existing labs, there are different kinds of labs. For example, if you take CP Laboratory, they give free service. They don't charge anything to the farmer. And some companies, they give subsidized price. For example, Thapar Water Base, they set up a few aqua labs in Andhra Pradesh and other areas. They give almost 50% subsidy, or they charge very less. And some labs, they charge reasonably, and some charges, they charge premium. So for example, in my lab, we charge premium, but we get much more samples than any of those labs. Why? Because if you charge more, you can give better service, you can appoint better quality people, and you can give better service so that people will believe you. So belief is the most important aspect to run the lab successfully. So the way forward, as a student, how much knowledge one student should acquire in order to run a aqua lab successfully? So my mentor always uses an example of a car and its headlight. If the car is a farmer, and the headlight should be a consultant or laboratory person. Can you please unmute? Hello.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Please. Ravi sir, please unmute yourself. Ravi sir, please unmute yourself.
Ravi sir, please unmute yourself.
Please. Okay, it's okay. So how much knowledge you should have in order to guide your farmer? My mentor always uses it to give an example of a car and its headlight. Suppose if you start from Pune to Mumbai during nighttime, you just believe in your headlights and move forward. So you should have little extra knowledge than the farmer. Then you can successfully run an aqua lab. And another strategy is, before start setting up an aqua lab, you should have minimum 1 year experience, that too 6 months in the field and 6 months in an aqua lab. And within this 1 year, you should be able to answer all the FAQs. Whenever a farmer comes to a lab, he will ask a few questions. So there will be a maximum of 200 questions. Suppose if you take shrimp farming, there will be a maximum of 200 FAQs. If you can note down, if you can answer all these FAQs, you can successfully run an aqua lab. And another thing is, my mentor always used to say, don't be cheap on your way to greatness. This is a very important point. Don't be cheap on your way to greatness. And then, sorry, something wrong? Okay. So what are the regulations in Andhra Pradesh to set up an aqua lab? So it should be an illegal entity. You should register with either the Department of Fisheries or whatever the regulatory body in your state. It should be a legal entry. So in Andhra Pradesh, Department of Fisheries is registering all the aqua labs. Otherwise, if the Department of State Fisheries is not recognizing, you can register in MSME. MSME is in a central government thing. You can register medium and small scale enterprises. You can register straight away. You can go to the website and you can register within 15 minutes. And then in Andhra Pradesh and even in other states, if your turnover is crossing 20 lakhs, there is an 18% GST. So you have to register for GST if your turnover, annual turnover is crossing 20 lakhs. Then you need a PAN card. You have to register with income tax and get your PAN card. And every year you have to, it may be an individual, it may be a partnership firm, or it may be an LLP. You have to file your returns every year. This is the regulation part. And then this is my registration under State Fisheries Department, Government of Andhra Pradesh. So every 3 years we have to renew this registration. And then how much investment do you need? This is the most important thing. So if you want to set up an aqua lab, how much investment you need? It depends upon several factors. For example, if you have an own facility, your investment will be much, much less. You can rent a facility. Sometimes there are few mobile labs. So mobile labs, the investment is different. And it again depends on the size of the laboratory, scale of your laboratory. And you can set up an aqua clinic as low as with 50,000 rupees. And there are some industries, there are some companies, they set up their labs with 50 lakhs investment also. So it varies from company to company, person to person, and equipment to equipment. I'll give you an example. For example, if you buy a refractometer to measure the salinity, so you can get it for 1500 rupees on Amazon. On the other hand, if you want to go for a digital refractometer, it will cost you 15,000. So there is a 10 times cost difference. In the same manner, microscopes also, you can buy a microscope just for 10,000 rupees, and you can buy a microscope for 1 lakh rupee also. So the investment depends on the equipment you select and the scale you want to go further, go ahead. And then the loans are available. Government banks are offering loans on all these investments, and some subsidy schemes are also available. For example, in order to set up a PCR lab, MPDA, MPDA is offering 50% subsidy. Now there are some schemes in NFDB also. So you can avail those subsidy, especially in Andhra Pradesh, there are some subsidy schemes by Department of Fisheries also. So depending upon your state, you can go for subsidy also. So then another important thing is, there are several labs, several corporate companies, big corporates, they have set up very big labs in Andhra Pradesh, but they close it down because it depends on the quality of the person, not the quality of the equipment you have. This is very much important. The success of the lab depends on the quality of the person, the subject the person is having. It depends on the subject or the quality of the person, not on the quality of your equipment. So one of my teacher who has set up a lab in Bhimavaram with 50,000 rupees is operating much better than a corporate company who has invested 50 lakhs. And then, so what are the tests you can do? So normally in an aqua lab, first we start with the soil testing. There are different parameters of soil. And then we go for water quality parameters like physical parameters, chemical parameters, and biological parameters. So there are several chemical parameters like pH, salinity, alkalinity, hardness, calcium, magnesium, ammonia, nitrite, nitrate, dissolved oxygen, hydrogen sulfide, iron, etc. And then you can also do microbiology, total plate count, Vibrio specific media is available, and Aeromonas and Pseudomonas specific media is also available. And if you can further, you can do MIC value, minimum inhibitory concentration. For example, if you want to suggest a chemical, there are certain sanitizers or disinfectants. Suppose you want to go for a disinfectant, you can test in the lab at what concentration it is killing the pathogens. And you can specifically suggest the farmer to go for that particular dosage so that you get a desired results. And as far as fish is concerned, there are certain antibiotics are allowed. And you can go for antibiotic sensitivity test before prescription so that you get an accurate result and you can avoid all these problems of antimicrobial resistance. Then this is selective media for Aeromonas. Any of the students, can you comment what media is this? I want students to comment. What media is this? What media do you use for Aeromonas? Okay. Any comments? I'm hello.
Dear students, please unmute and answer the question.
Any one of you, so that I can feel that you are following my. Okay.
There might be a technical issue because I think they could not able to unmute.
Okay. So then coming to immunology. After microbiology, we can go for some immunology tests. So normally we use rapid test kits like lateral flow test strip, a similar kit which we are using now for COVID to test antibodies. And a latest agglutination test. This is most common in fish pathogens. And there are some dot ELISA kits are also available. And now the PCR is most popular in, especially in shrimp diseases, especially for all the known shrimp viruses, we go for a PCR test. And in order to set up your PCR test, see, you can buy a PCR machine just for 1 lakh rupees, or also you can buy a PCR machine for 20 lakh rupees. So that is why investment, based on your investment, you can select the equipment. The result will be same. So this is the rapid test kit which we use to detect white spot virus. Within 10 minutes, you can deliver the results. This is based on antigen antibody. Then this is the immunodiagnostic developed by CIFA, which is very popular among fish disease diagnostic labs. With this kit, you can test Aeromonas, Edwardsilla, Pseudomonas, Vibrio and Flavobacterium species. And this is how the get the results, a positive control, negative control and test. Based on the agglutination, you can say whether it is positive or negative. And this is the latest machine, which is very cheap, pocket micro or pocket view. It's a PCR machine. You can get PCR test results within 30 minutes. And this is OIE approved. World Organization for Animal Health has approved this PCR machine. And it costs around 1 lakh rupees. So coming to further tests, microscopic. And especially if you are a fishery student, you should be thorough with all the gross signs of the diseases. For example, if you're handling fish pathology lab, you should be thorough with all the gross signs of fish. Sometimes based on the gross signs itself, there are some signs we call it as pathognomonic. So by looking at that, you can say this is a particular specific disease and you can treat it. No need of further diagnosis. Can you name any one such disease? By looking at the symptoms, you can say, this is this particular disease.
Can WSSV, sir.
WSSV. White spot. No. There are several reasons for white spot virus.
Yeah, bacterial or viral.
Can you name a fish disease? By just looking at this, you can say, by looking at the symptoms, the clinical signs, you can say this is this particular disease. Myxobolus.
Yeah. Very
easy. So easily visible. Argus, Lernia, Ergophilus. Just by looking at the fish, you can say this is particular Ergophilus or Lernia disease, and you can treat it. Okay, and some pathogens we can observe under microscope and confirm it. Can you name one particular disease, parasitic disease, which you can confirm with the help of your microscope? Samaj, are you able to understand my speech? Are you following? Hello?
Yes, sir. We are following, sir. Yeah. Students, please answer.
I want the students to respond so that I'll get some energy.
Sir, actually, we usually mute the students so that no disturbance is created to the.
I think they can send the chat now. They can.
Please put in the chat box, students.
Respond in the chat box.
Yeah, I want them to respond in the chat. So this is to know whether they are able to follow me or not. They are able to understand my speech or not. Do you have a fish pathology practicals? Do you have fish pathology practicals? Fish pathology mein
koi practical? Yes, they have it. They have very much, and I'm not sure why they are not able to reply, like for simple questions like Primula short media and all these things. Students, please put your replies in the chat box.
Okay, so then you can check the seed quality with microscope, especially in the shrimp. We go for all the morphometric characters like muscle gut ratio, gut fullness, clarity of the muscle, condition of the hepatopancreas. If there is any necrosis and all, we can observe under microscope and we can give report. And then plankton. Plankton is especially fish culture. There are certain toxic phytoplankton species are there that causes damage to the liver and kill the fish. Can you name which is one toxic plankton species? Can you name one plankton species that is toxic to fish?
Microcystis.
Yeah, very good. Microcystis. And I want the students to respond, sir. Okay. And then histology. Suppose if there is a new disease, the only way forward is to do histology. With the histology, you know what went wrong, what organ failed, why it is dying. So with the histology only, you can make out. Normally, we don't do histology in shrimp pathology labs. We fix the sample in Davidson's fixative with alcohol, formalin, and acetic acid. After 48 hours of fixation, we transfer it to 70% ethanol. And then we send it to the government lab, either to Rajiv Gandhi Center for Aquaculture or Central Institute of Fish Brackish Water Aquaculture, CIBA. So they do slides for us and they'll send it back us. And you should be able to read it. If you are running and if you are operating a lab, you should be able to read all the lesions of the common diseases. And then you can test different inputs. For example, farmers are using bleaching powder, they are using lime, they are using iodophos, they are using benzalkonium chloride, and they are using potassium chloride. All these inputs, you should be able to test it. So bleaching powder, what percentage of chlorine is there? Liming, what percentage of calcium is there? Iodophor, what percentage of iodine is there? And BKC, there are different grades are available, 50% and 80%. Whether it is 50% or not, you can confirm it. and potassium chloride, what is the percentage of potassium chloride? We use flame photometer for this. So this is how you can test different inputs and make more money by testing all these things. And one more thing is, you can also test the total plate count of probiotics. There are several probiotics are available in the market. You can do the basic test, total plate count, with a general purpose medium. And so then, okay, this is a fish with a gross sign. So what do you call this sign? What do you call this? Can you make out anything? There are two gross signs. There are two clinical signs. Can you make out? As a student, you should be thorough with all the clinical signs, external signs of the fish diseases, and you should be able to identify all the internal organs of the fish. So you should be able to identify a healthy fish and diseased fish. Then only it will be very easy to guide the farmer. So you should be able to identify all the internal organs. Internal organs like especially liver, spleen, kidney, gut, gallbladder, and reproductive organs. You should be able to identify. And then further, you can go for nutrition test. Especially in nutrition, you can set up a lab with the proximate analysis. Proximate analysis, we do protein, fat, carbohydrate, and moisture. Most of the farmers, they send samples for proximate analysis. And some farmers, they'll ask only for protein content. So different feeds have different protein contents, and different raw materials have different protein content. So you can check that protein content and report to the farmers. And there are some advanced tests. Some labs have it, are going for it, and some labs, they don't have it. And especially antibiotics is a major issue now. It's a burning issue. Antibiotics, you can test with the different methods. Like most of the labs, they have ELISA. ELISA is not that sensitive, and especially shrimp, we have to go for LC-MS-MS, liquid chromatographic mass spectrometer, mass spectrometer, mass spectrography, mass spectrography. Especially the shrimp raw material, it is mandatory to check all the antibiotics, especially the metabolites of furazolidine and the metabolites of chloramphenicol. And you should have a CAA registration for that. And see, suppose there are several companies, they are selling health products. All the health products, they must send their samples for antibiotic testing, and that lab should be NABL accredited. So if you have an LC-MS-MS, you can go for NABL accreditation, and you can accept the samples from, there are thousands of products available in the market. Each and every products, they must get it tested for antibiotics. And you can also go for heavy metals testing, like with the help of AAS, atomic absorption spectrophotometer. But no aqua lab has AAS in India. We are sending it to other industrial laboratories like Vimta lab, ITA lab, etc. There is a scope for one particular one lab with AAS in aquaculture. So if you can afford, you can go for it. And then I was discussing about multiple streams of income. How do you get different sources of income as a consultant, after setting up an aqua lab? The one thing is, in order to run a successful lab, you should have some field exposure. So for that, you must start your consultancy. So morning, what I am doing is, I go to field, give service to the farmers, and then come back, I sit in the lab. So that I get more number of samples, I get connected to the farmers. So even after sitting in the lab, we analyze the sample and we give report and we suggest them what to do, how to treat a particular disease. And then we go there and we follow whether the treatment is working or not. And another thing is you can start training. In my lab, I start training people on different aspects of all these water quality parameters, microbiology, pathology. So I conduct regular trainings on all, especially on pathology, I conduct regular training. And you can do product trials. Suppose a particular company, for example, there are several companies abroad, they want to launch their product in India. They want their products to be tested in the field. So they send their samples to our lab. We test in the lab for the efficiency. For example, I told you about MIC value or antibiotic sensitivity, all these tests we do in the lab. And then we do field trials and we report them. They pay huge amount of money. Foreign companies, they pay huge amount of money when compared to Indian companies. So product trials must be one of your portfolio. And another thing is research. You can do contract research and you can also develop some test kits. Suppose there are several water quality parameters, for example, ammonia, alkalinity, hardness. You simply, what you can do is you can concentrate the reagents. For example, for alkalinity titration, you are using N by 50 sulfuric acid. Instead, you make it N by 5. So you are concentrating it 10 times. You have to drop calibrate it and make a kit so that you can make some money out of it. This is how there are different methods to make more money in the industry. And then quality control in the aqua lab is utmost important. Every laboratory should have a laboratory manual with all the standard protocols. And then after receiving a sample, sample code is important. In my lab, how do we code the sample is, we start with a date first and then order. Suppose the farmer is in the third farmer that came to my lab today. So date, the order, and the bond number. We mark it on the sample. So different labs have different lab code systems. And then quality check standards. So suppose you are doing ammonia. Once in a while, you have to run standards so that you will be able to know whether the test you are doing is perfect or not. So regular quality control standards, regularly you have to run the standards to know the quality of your test. And aquaculture, especially in shrimp farming, we participated in inter-calibration test. For example, Arizona University or sometimes the Central Institute of Brackish Water Aquaculture, they send unknown samples to us, especially tissue with a known pathogen. So we have to analyze the test that samples and send back the reports. They will evaluate and they'll give you a certificate whether the test you're doing is perfect or not. And another thing is calibration of the equipment. Most of the suppliers, they take care of annual maintenance contract for my PCR mission. I've taken an AMC. So every year, once they'll come and inspect, check the weather, the temperature is perfect or not, so that you can give better quality. And some laboratories, they have automated the reports. The moment you enter your test values, they calculate the test results and generate a report, and automatically they mail or they send by SMS or they send by WhatsApp to the farmers. I don't have this automated system, but some laboratories in Andhra Pradesh, they have automated their entire reporting system. And documentation is very much important. So if you have a documentation, you know what is the trend, whether the particular disease is spreading or any new, if suppose in case of any new disease, you can report to the authorities also. So the documentation is much more important to know the pattern of your disease. And then manpower. So if you yourself are setting up a laboratory, you can be a promoter, and you can be a promoter come technical manager. And if you have all the skills, you can appoint lab assistants. For example, water quality, you can select a BSc candidate with a chemistry background. For microbiology, again, a graduate with microbiology. Like that, you can select a few lab assistants. And one person should know all the things. You should be a master of all these tests and parameters. And then you can have few non-technical lab attendants also to help you in especially receiving the sample, cleaning the equipment and all. So in my lab, there are three technical lab assistants are working under me and one lab attendant. So another important point is you should get training regularly. Learning is a continuous process. So even till today, I'm attending several training programs. In some of the training programs, I'm the oldest person. I don't feel shy. I don't feel shy to attend and sit along with the students. And personal training is very much important to run a lab successfully. And once you get trained, you can train your staff so that you can give a better quality service to the customers. And there are several organizations in India are offering training. For example, soil testing, there is the ICAR Delhi Pusa complex. So you can learn all the soil testing skills. There is one particular lab called the FIP Laboratory in Delhi. So you can attend a training program. Every year they're offering training program on soil testing. I learned soil testing from ICAR. And there are different central organizations like CIBA, CIFA, CMFRI, RGCA, CAFE, CAFT, NBFGRI, SAFT, etc. Every year they have a calendar schedule. You can go to their website and have a look at the training programs they are offering and select the one which is suitable for you. Even in India, there are several organizations like Mahidol University is offering a world-class program on shrimp pathology. Arizona University is also offering a very good program on shrimp pathology. If you are interested in shrimp pathology, you must go for any of those, either Mahidol University or Arizona University to become an expert in shrimp pathology. So my mentor always used to tell me that there is a golden triangle you have to follow. Golden triangle, like you learn, you do it, and you teach, so that you will never forget the subject. Learn, do, teach is the right approach to learn the subject or any skill. So that is the same pattern I am following. So every year I used to attend one or two training programs minimum. So after the training program, I used to come and practice it, and then I train people. And last year I have attended a training program in Bhubaneswar, learned on different diagnostic techniques. This is SEM, electron microscope. And you should always practice advanced techniques. So this is a bioflock shrimp farm in Andhra Pradesh, Nellore. Here we have produced highest quantity per acre, highest production per acre we have achieved with the help of bioflock technology. This I learned from different teachers on bioflock, and then I practiced, and we are able to produce maximum production. Especially we have harvested around 16 tons in 1 acre pond. This is the highest, it's a record harvest in India so far. So again, another important factor is safety in the laboratory. There should be a fire safety equipment and chemical safety. So you have to arrange all the chemicals in alphabetical order, and then product data sheets should be there for all the chemicals that you have in the laboratory. And you should train your staff. Suppose there is an acid spill, how to respond. You have to train your staff, and there should be guidelines. You should be able to provide them guidelines so that it will be safe to the people who are working with you. And then coming to the profitability, this is the most important thing. And profitability depends on scale and number of samples you receive. For example, you set up your laboratory with 50,000 rupees, and if you can get 10 samples a day, you can make some money. Suppose on the other hand, if you set up a laboratory with 50 lakhs investment, if you get to even 50 samples also, it will not break. You don't get break even. So it depends on the scale and the salaries that you pay to your staff. And in my lab, if I am doing water quality, I get around 70% margin on that. In microbiology, we get 60% margin. In molecular biology, that means PCR, we get around 30% margin. And microscopy, there is no expenses involved. It's your skill. So your skill pays you more. You get 100% margin. Suppose the farmer is paying 500 rupees for a microscopic observation. It's 500 rupees is profit for you. There is no expense involved in that. So water quality 70%, microbiology 60%, molecular biology we get very less margin. And general observation, we charge it's 100% profit to us. So this is about profitability of aqua clinic. And while making a project, bankable project report, you should incorporate all those things. There should be fixed costs. For example, you are constructing a laboratory or you are buying equipment. All these will come under fixed costs. And then recurring expenses like your power bill, your chemicals, your salary, your staff, your taxes and all. So after deducting your total sale minus your expenses, you get profit. And from the profit, auditors, they deduct a depreciation. For most of the aquaculture equipment, the depreciation period is around 6 years. So then after depreciation, you have to pay your taxes based on your net profit. This is auditors will take care of this project reports. Suppose if you're going for a bank loan or if you're going for a subsidy, you should submit your project report. If anybody wants, I have a project report of Echo One Center from one of my friends. I can share it with you later. So this is about project report. And very proud to say that every year I get an appreciation certificate from Department of Ministry of Finance, Income Tax Department. I get an appreciation certificate. This is a proof that I'm operating successfully. So if you have any, thank you very much. That's all for now. If you have any doubts, you can unmute yourself and ask me the questions.
Dear students, you can unmute yourself and ask your queries.
If you have any query or if you have any doubt.
Dear students, please ask your queries.
Good morning, Dr. Ravi Kumar.
Good morning, sir.
I am Dr. Anush Tyagi from College of Fisheries, Naina, Kadwaku only. So it was very wonderful to listen to your presentation. And before the students start asking, I had a query of my own, out of my own curiosity, actually, since considering your field experience. Actually, when I was in College of Fisheries, Mangalore in MFSC in 2005, we had a LC-MS-MS there, and we used to test lots of fish and shellfish samples from coastal areas for getting chloramphenicol and nitrofurans residues, actually.
Okay.
That time we used to get quite a much number of residues, though we never could publish it. That is a different story.
Okay.
So what is, as you are in the, since then I lost touch actually, since you are in the field for so long, what is your experience of now using the antibiotic residues in the antibiotics in the aquaculture industry? That particular
thing. Sir, especially in shrimp farming, antibiotic usage has come down because of several restrictions. But in fish culture, still people are using it. Some people are going for polyculture, shrimp and fish. Fish, they are treating with antibiotics so that that particular material, they are getting antibiotic AOZ metabolized.
It's
COVID has come down drastically.
Chloramphenicol, any idea, sir?
Chloramphenicol, not much. People are using Firazolidine. And Firazolidine withdrawal period is much more than all other antibiotics.
Yes, sir. It's a nitrofurantoin group.
Yeah.
So I request other students also to interact with the sir.
You can understand.
Sorry, sir.
I want students to interact.
Yeah, that's what, sir. I please, students, put your queries in the chat box. We can read for you also in case you are unable to unmute yourself.
Somebody has asked me for a presentation copy. Sure, sir. I'll share right now. No problem. I can share it.
Hello. Can I ask one question? Yeah. I'm audible?
Yes.
Please.
Okay. Good morning to all of you. I'm Dr. Vivek Shastav. Ravi sir, very good morning. And Advasu, I have so many friends over there. I'm assistant professor at Kamdhi University, Gujarat. So I am not a student, but still the very big point Ravi sir told that we should make a golden triangle, like learning, doing, and then teach. So in that context, actually, my question is this. Sir, basically, we are just like, you know, we have started, this is a new university, and actually we are engaged in fisheries student post-graduation. So, sir, actually, sometimes what I faced, like, you know, being I was studied in CAP Mumbai, and I have done my PG, PhD from there. So here itself, actually, I just wanted to make my students to take all this water quality analysis, especially this water quality, soil analysis, and this basic instruments like spectrophotometry, then ELISA and all these things. So can we get a single place where we can get a training, or in your institute or your training center or anywhere like this? Because what I believe, like the person who's in field, who's take caring of things, everyday's problem, he can make it more efficiently, he can handle more efficiently this thing. So sir, Ravi sir, is there any place where, like, you know, I can make a schedule and I can take myself as well as my students over there?
So it's very difficult to get in one particular place, sir. For example, PCR I have learned from Mangalore Fisheries College, Dr. Karna Sagar. So soil.
No, sir. You have learned everything, and you are having everything at a one point at your academy. So I'm asking this.
So if they can come and schedule, stay with me for 1 week, they can learn several things.
Yeah, so sure, definitely I'll get back to you in that, and I'll definitely write an email regarding this. I also wanted personally to get
all shrimp pathology, they can learn from me. If they're interested, yes, in shrimp, especially, definitely I can help.
Yes, sir. Means from water, microbiology, and our microscopy.
Basic things they can learn from my lab.
Definitely. Thank you, sir, for giving wonderful.
If anybody is interested to set up an aqua lab, definitely I'll help them.
Thank you.
I find Fisheries College Muthukur students. They came to my lab. They'll come to my lab every year, and they'll learn several things.
Yes, sir. Sure, I'll get back to you on this.
You're welcome, sir.
So it's okay, thank you. Thank you.
To train students.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Hello, sir. Myself, Pradeep.
Sir.
Hello.
Yeah, welcome.
Is that audible?
Yeah, it's clear, sir.
Sir. You mentioned the Aqua One Center. So, what the project which may be taken in different parts of all states, right, sir? So, yeah. What might be the cost for establishing one such center, sir?
So, it's a scheme up to 1 crore, sir.
1 crore.
It's an NFDB funded scheme.
Sir.
It's up to 1 crore you can.
So I'm working as assistant professor in agriculture college. Okay. So if I need any help, definitely I will contact you, sir, if you don't mind.
Sure, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. And the session was very wonderful, very informative.
Thank you, sir.
And the methodology of delivering and convincing the audience was superb, sir. Thank you, sir.
I have one question. Sir, you have told regarding some rapid diagnostics, ALDA, field level diagnostics. Yes. Since you are having a field experience, What do you think the rapid diagnostic or field level diagnostics will help our farmers to improve the fish production or shrimp production?
Yeah, especially sir, as far as fish farming is concerned, there are common symptoms for several diseases. The hemorrhage, if you take hemorrhage, I have shown you one picture of a fish hemorrhage. There are several reasons for hemorrhage. So if you have a field diagnostic kit, you can draw the hemolymph, take the serum, and you can test within 1 hour so that you can say this is the pathogen responsible for it.
Okay.
Especially shrimp lateral flow test, within 10 minutes we can say whether white spot is present or absent. And Mangalore Fisheries College has developed one immunodiagnostic kit called as a Rapid Dot. Now they are not supplying. Earlier they were supplying. It's 300 rupees, and we are able to run 3 samples. So each sample cost is 100 rupees. It is quite affordable for the farmer as well as for the laboratory.
No. Yes, sir. So I was part of that. See, okay. Wow, developing that rapid dot kit.
Yeah.
See, now since our degree program completed and my advisor has retired, so in the end of his period, we transferred the technology to Virbac. I think now Virbac is selling that product.
Well, it's not.
And sir, one more thing. See, what is the market status for this rapid diagnostic in shrimp culture?
Huge, sir, huge. Huge. And so far, we are using only imported kits. But Tamil Nadu, Dr. Sahul Hamid,
yes,
has developed a kit. Soon it may come to the market. It's in the final stage. I visited his lab.
I just have a query.
Yes, sir.
Have you, in your field experience, I'm talking about particularly about the shrimp diagnostic kits.
Okay.
Is there any, what are the reliability of the drugs? See, although they might have been, they are from good reliable companies, but have you ever faced problems of false negative or false positive results sometime like this out of your experience?
So far there is no false positives.
Okay.
Maybe false negatives depending upon the sensitivity of the kit. So we use all these diagnostic kits in the field whenever there is mortality.
Okay.
So for screening we use PCR.
Okay.
If it is a screening, we go for PCR. If it is diagnosis, we go for rapid test kits.
Okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
Right. Sir, one more thing. See, students, they could, they are getting difficulty in sending a message in the chat box because they are using a mobile. Okay. And they have sent few questions in our WhatsApp group.
Okay, sir.
They are asking a question related to our shrimp farming, which is going on in our inland saline areas.
Okay.
See, there is one question related to disease. So yeah. He's asking a question like, see, we have EHP disease in our country. So, and there is no much mortality, it might be a running mortality.
Okay.
Whether there will be a major economic loss due to this EHP disease, or we can manage with some medicine or something. So,
as far as EHP is concerned, there is no treatment available. And even in future, we cannot expect any treatment for EHP. The reason is the outer cover of EHP contains chitin. So if you want to kill EHP, you have to kill the shrimp also. You have to give a such a high dose. So we cannot expect a treatment for EHP in the near future. So we can prevent it, first thing. And second thing, even with low EHP, you can get a reasonable growth. It depends on the prevalence of EHP. If the load is high, you don't get proper growth. If the load is low, in spite of Dr. Rajendran has did a study on that, even with the low EHP counts, people are able to get good growth. And it's published by Dr. Rajendran. He's in CIFP right now, I think.
And so there is one more question. As you told that in Aqua Clinic Lab, there are several components, water quality testing, soil testing, and molecular diagnosis. And he is asking the question like, whether we have to, with respect to the profitability and with starting the Aqua Clinic Lab, whether we have to start with the water quality analysis or only a feed analysis or disease diagnosis, or we have to combine all the things?
I suggest you to start with water quality laboratory, then scale it up. Gain the confidence of farmers, then that's how I did it. I started with a water quality laboratory, then I scaled it up.
And there is one more question related to Aqua Clinic only.
Yeah,
and sir, if I want to set up an Aqua Clinic laboratory, so as you told, I can get a funding from a Aqua One Center.
Okay.
So to get that funding from that scheme, so how to proceed it? So directly I can apply, or what way?
Directly you can apply to NFDB. All the details are there in the NFDB website. And I recommend you never look for all these subsidies and all. Depend on your own efficiency. Never look for subsidies. For example, I'll quote an example. There are several RAS systems were set up because they're getting subsidies. None of them were successful. Nobody is running successfully. So never look for subsidies and all. Focus on results.
So there is one more question.
Yes.
See, in shrimp farming, we were in Indian shrimp farming, we were doing a culture using Pineus monoda.
Okay.
And due to WSSV disease, we have shifted to Latopinius onami.
Okay.
And now there are few reports and in the Latopinius onami also. So how we can go forward in this aspect?
Sir, it's not few. There are several cases of white spot virus in Venami culture also. Venami is SPF. It is free from all the known pathogens when you import it. But white spot is endemic. It's well established in our environment. So only the biosecurity, through proper biosecurity, you can prevent it. But Venami is not resistant. I think got my point.
Yes, sir. I think he has got the information. And sir, one more question. See, he is asking the question like, see, this state or whatever, the North India is a landlocked state. So we have a inland aquaculture.
Okay.
So if you set up an aqua clinic in our inland aquaculture area, is it profitable or not?
So you can set up a water quality laboratory. So molecular diagnostic, you may not get enough samples to get profitability, but you can go for water quality laboratory. And I already told you should focus on multiple streams of income, like field trials, contract research.
Sir, thank you, sir. It was a very good session. And we also got a lot of information from your presentation. And I'm sure that our student has got an information and they were inspired by your talk, So they may go for a entrepreneurship for this related to aquaculture aspects.
Thank you, sir. For the opportunity.
Yeah. Now I will hand over the session to Anu sir to give what of students.
Naveen sir, can I ask one question? Last question.
Yes, please, please.
Ravi sir, again, this is Vivek Shah. So, sir, as you have discussed, like, congratulations that you have harvested 60 ton through bioflock.
16, sir.
And sir, again. 16 ton from that bioflock area. And sir, my question is this, because I engaged in bioflock, but I am just restricted myself to the fishes only. Okay. So, and near and about inland saline soil is a big problem, which is coming on the way in a very massive manner. So in Haryana, Rajasthan, and in Gujarat, in fact. So, sir, what will be your suggestion if, like, you know, now the trend in fishes generally, like they people are culturing, you know, in a 10,000 liter, 20,000 liter fishes. Okay. So basically they are taking up tilapia, then koi carp and some small size fishes.
Okay.
So whether it is advisable to culture in inland area in that 10,000, 20,000 tank shrimps, whether it will be fruitful or it's an area to explore.
Yeah, I'll quote a live example.
Yeah.
Okay. There are several people in Orissa, they have set up bioflock systems. Several, N number.
Right, sir.
Like 30 tons, 10 tons. Several people, they have set up bioflock systems. So initially they did IMC.
Yes, sir.
IMC is not suitable for bioflock. It's not growing. Then they shifted to Vietnam koi.
Right, sir.
So now nobody is there to buy.
Right, sir.
So they're not able to sell it.
Right, sir.
So it's not economically viable at this moment. Because the market is not there. Shrimp market is export. So whatever the quantity you produce, you can export it. But shrimp is a domestic consumption.
So, sir, means my point is this. Can we take up shrimp under this tank culture system in bioflock?
And it's very difficult because mineral profile, it will not match.
Mineral profile.
Okay. Especially mineral concentration and the ratio. Right. Both should match.
Okay. Means it's difficult at the point.
Yeah, you get much more running mortality, especially Punjab, Haryana. Running mortality is there. I visited a few farms in Punjab also.
Right.
So because of that mineral profile imbalance in that, there is a mortality.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Ravi sir and Srivastava, okay. I have few queries also from Ravi sir, but a very interesting topic. Dr. Srivastava, Dr. Ravi, about this bioflock, I want to discuss something. On an average, you will not believe that I get 5 to 10 calls every day on this bioflock farming in North India. As Ravi sir also told, and to my opinion also, we don't have any suitable species for bioflock farming in our northern states.
Yes.
Reason is, and second thing is that I never advocate, and as Ravi sir told, culturing IMC is in bioflock and then expecting a good profit. I don't think it is possible. Second thing is, what is basically, as scientists, it's our role. We have to educate the people. What is happening? Some people are luring the customers, just putting the videos on YouTube and all, and they are just proliferating this like anything, that we can get this much. But as per my opinion, I don't think any suitable. Okay, even if they go for tilapia, we don't have a good market of tilapia in northern India. And about shrimp, since I am looking up, and our team, Dr. Anuj, myself, and Dr. Naveen, we are looking into shrimp farming. They are looking into disease aspects. I am looking after culture aspects. But even we are not advocating farmers for bioflock in shrimp. As Ravi sir told, mineral profile is a big problem. Okay, we are educating them if they can aerate their bottom, they will get some added profit.
Yes.
But to my opinion, we don't have a suitable and viable species for bioflock in our northern India. I think you will agree with me on this point.
Sure, sir. Yes, you are right.
And Haryana and people, they have, many people have started, but we don't have a successful result so far. because we don't have a viable species. They have seen YouTubes, and the people got lured like anything. The people are selling those big tanks and all. They think that even मैं घर के छत के ऊपर भी अगर थोड़ा सा लगा दूँ तो like I can earn a lot of money. So this is the situation. Okay, Dr. Srivastava, you want to?
Prabhuji Singh, what is your means opinion? That's it's appreciable and it's correct up to a great extent, in fact. But my point is this, like, you know, the way we are, you know, because my personal experience, if I'm telling, like in North India, we are not everyday fish eaters, right? We are not taking fish every day, but in southern part, people are using it because they are getting wild catch and they are having good markets and all these things. But regarding bioflock, my point is that, like if we can even like in carps or in anything, like, you know, any kind of fishes, if we can improve the growth rate compared to the culture system, one point. Yes. Second point is that if we can improve the survival of the species as well. And third point is this, those farmers who don't have huge lands or pond area, if they can manage and can procure fishes for their livelihood or for the family, I think bioflock concept is very much suitable in that cases. I am sure that's very correct. We cannot go for large production in that, or for large production, we need to convert this bioflock system, or we need to take this bioflock system from tank to ponds. So this is my point. So we, I think, and the last point about anything, sludge, you know, sludge management is very poor. People, very few people knows how to manage sludge.
Yes.
If we can do that in an efficient manner, things may be in the right direction.
Yeah. You are absolutely right, Dr. Srivastava. But the only thing is, who are coming in even the bioflock systems, who the people who has not experienced, zero experience, he has not even handled once in life, how can he direct you to bioflock systems? Very tough for him.
And Dr. Srivastava, please listen.
Yes,
sir. It would be great that if you can continue discussion maybe offline later.
Okay, sure, sir.
I'm not, you're not audible, Dr. Okay, fine.
Sure, sir.
Please, we can continue this. Dr. Naveen, you can proceed with the vote of thanks.
Students, do you have any questions? Sir, please proceed, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. First of all, I thank Dr. Ravi Kumar, sir. Sir, thank you very much for presenting this wonderful webinar, actually, on entrepreneurship opportunity in aquaclinics. And first, I forgot to introduce myself. I am Dr. Anuj Tyagi. I am the assistant professor at College of Fisheries, Gadwasu. And as you mentioned, Dr. Karuna Sagar's lab, actually, I did my MFSC and PhD from Sri Microbiology from Bangalore only, in their guidance. And sir, I am very much thankful for providing this wonderful webinar to us. And I also would like to summarize a few points of take-home message from your webinar, and just to show the students that how they can use it. The first thing, sir, mentioned, that you can see first opening slide, sir, has mentioned the important thing we mentioned, that whatever the work you do, you have to be honest with your farmers. And that is the important thing, sir, started even before saying anything else. He mentioned that you can cheat the farmer maybe once or twice, but your market reputation and everything will be gone. That is a very important point, which every student, if they want to be entrepreneur or they want to start their own, they have to understand. And sir has mentioned very good example, like in the form of car and headlight. And also, what was very wonderful, that sir has mentioned lots of practical tips, like how much experience you should have. Like he mentioned, you should have experience of 1 year, in 6 months plus 6 months. How much you should know? You should know at least 200 FAQs, at least to start your work, and then you can learn on the job. So that is very important. And also, sir has mentioned important things like how to start the business, how you initiate. Some people, they get discouraged just because they think that aquaclinic is actually a very costly investment. But as sir has mentioned, that you can start as low as with 50,000 and start with a small water quality lab, and then you proceed further to get trust with the farmer and proceed further. So that is very important. And also one important thing that students should know, that not only you are going to earn money by testing your samples. Sir has mentioned that income diversification is very much important in the terms of consultancy, training, research, and product trials and development of kits, which can always help you to get the extra income. Sir, we are very much thankful to you and also sharing some of the profitability aspect of this particular aquaclinic things. Basically, as you mentioned, the things we generally ignore, like the things we generally ignore in our learning years, like water quality, microbiology, or classical microbiology and microscopy, they are actually more profitable when you start your own business. Like every student, they will be more focused mess of PCR seek leta hun, real time PCR seek leta hun. But every student, as sir has mentioned, that profitability in the molecular biology is only 30%, whereas in the microscopy it can be as high as 100% because there is no input required. So we are very much thankful, sir, and it was a wonderful discussion and wonderful webinar, and thank you once alone. I would also like to thank few other people. Our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Indrajit Singh, our Dr. S.P.S. Gumman, who is the PI of this IDP project and Dean College of Veterinary Science, our own Dean, Dr. Miradi Anson, Dean College of Fisheries, and our Dr. Vanit Indrakot, who is the department head of the Department of Aquatic Environment. I would also like to thank Dr. Naveen Kumar B.T. and Dr. Amandeep Kaur for organizing this wonderful webinar. I also like to thank Dr. Prabhjit Singh, Dr. Vivek Srivastav, and all the faculties who joined and offered their critical inputs during the discussion. Thank you once and all, and thank you all. And at the last, I would like to thank the participants without whom this webinar would have not been possible. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you, Ravi, sir.
Thank you.
We were really blessed to have you, and we will be very shortly taking your services again. I'll be discussing shortly, and we are really enlightened by your today's lecture, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Sir, thank you, Ravi, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Please, if we close the meeting, Dr. Amandeep.
Dr. Amandeep, we can close the meeting.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.